Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 5.5 that is taken from chapter number 5, Torsion, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the gear attached to the fixed end steel shaft are subjected to torque shown in figure 5-19A. If the shear modulus of elasticity is 80 gigapascal and the shaft has a diameter of 14 millimeter, determine the displacement of tooth P on the gear A. The shaft turns freely within the bearing at B. So you can see this is shaft and that is fixed at point E and that is applied various torque of different magnitude at point A, C and D. And this shaft freely rotates at bearing B. So what we have to find, we have to determine the displacement of tooth P on gear A. So we will find it whether this P will rotate in this direction or in this direction and how much this rotate. So let's start with the solution. So for that we will need angle of twist and what we will do is that you can see we will find the torque in each segment AC, in segment AD and in segment AE. Clear? So let's take, you can see the torque between the segment AB is constant throughout this. So what if you cut this at this point, clear, and draw the free body diagram. So I will draw it over here. It will be like this. This is the shaft. For example, this is the shaft and this is the gear and this is point A. So let if I cut it in region AC, so you can see that this shaft is at point A, you have a counterclockwise torque. You can see over here, this is counterclockwise torque, which is 150 Newton into meter. So in order to balance it, we will have a clockwise torque. Clear? So this will be equal to TAC. And this TAC will be also equal to 150 Newton into meter. Now for segment this segment AD or you can see CD. So what if you cut it over here and draw the free body diagram? So you will get the results will be like this. This will be your gear A there. This will be your shaft AC. And at C, you will have a gear like this. There, this is your C. And this is your shaft CD, which is cut it like this. And we can see this is the axis of this shaft. And at A, we have a counterclockwise torque, which is 150 Newton into meter. At C, you have a torque of 218 Newton into meter that is clockwise. So you can see this is clockwise. There. So what we will do is that you can see this clockwise is greater than this 150. So overall you will have a counterclockwise torque in this direction and this will be equal to TCD. So TCD can be obtained if you take counterclockwise is positive. So 150 minus 280 plus TCD is equal to zero. So from here TCD will be equal to 150 minus 280 will give you minus 130. So minus 130 when go toward the right hand side, it will be this will be minus 130, 150 minus 130. Yes, so this will be 130 Newton into meter. Okay, so as we have assumed that this clockwise torque, sorry, this is 180 clockwise, 150 is counterclockwise. So net torque will be, in order to balance it, it should be counterclockwise. Now we will find this torque in segment DE. So what we will do is that we will section it over here and draw the free body diagram. So again, this is shaft, this is gear A, clear. This is shaft AC. Now here you have again a gear of C, this is C, this is gear D at this point, Okay. And this is your shaft DE. You can take it at the end, till the end. So this is the axis of this shaft. There at A, you can see you have a counterclockwise torque. So this is counterclockwise. This is 150 Newton into meter. At C, you have a clockwise torque, which is 280 Newton into meter. And at D, you also have a clockwise torque like this. So this is 40 Newton into meter. So what will be the direction of torque at this? This torque will be equal to TDE. And you can see that this 280 and 40, they are again in clockwise. So I can write it as minus 280 minus 40 plus 150 will be plus this TDE, because this TDE will be also in counterclockwise direction. In order to balance it, it will be equal to 0. So minus 280 minus 40 plus 150 will give you minus 170, and when it move toward the right hand side, so TDE will be equal to 170 Newton into meter. So this is how we can find this torque at different sections. So by inspection, the torque in segment AC is 150, DE, CD is 130, and DE is 170 Newton into meter. Yet constant throughout each segment. So now using right hand rule. So what does it says that, and establish the sign convention that positive direction torque is always away from the section of the shaft. What does it mean that positive torque is directed away from the section of the shaft? So from this, we can conclude that TAC is 150, positive 150 Newton into meter, because it is away from the, you can see it is away from the this applied torque. I will repeat that positive torque is directed away. This is directed away from the section of the end of the shaft. So TAC is 150. We will take TCD is minus 130 Newton into meter, and TDE, because it is also in counterclockwise and it is opposite to the that, so it will be minus 170 Newton into meter. Okay, so you will get this. So from that, if I draw the torque diagram along the length, so let this is 0.4 meter, this is 0.3, total is from this point till this point it is 0.7, and at the end 0.5. this is 0.5, for example. So here the total length will be 1.2 meter, at here 0.7 meter, and here you will have 0.4 meter. Okay, starting on y-axis you have torque, that will be in Newton into meter. So at point A, you can see at point A you have 150 Newton into meter. So again, moving from point A till C, you can see you have a, in order to balance it, you should have a clockwise torque, which is given as 150 Newton into meter. And by using that right hand tool rule and established sign convention, the positive torque is away from the section end of the shaft. So what we will do is that, let this is 150, this point is 150, for example, Newton into meter. So from this point till 0.4 meter, it will remain same. Now you can see you have minus 280. So minus 150 plus 150 minus 280 will give you minus 130. So it will move toward to minus 130. So this is minus 130. And now moving from C to D, there is no other. So it will remain same. Now here you can see you have this 40 Newton that is given over here. So this is also negative. So minus 130 minus 40 is minus 170. So let this is minus 170. Okay. Now moving from this point till end, you can see you have constant, and at the end you have plus 170, will bring it to zero. So this is the torque diagram over the length of this shaft. Once you get this, you will find the angle of twist. So I will write angle of twist. So for angle of twist, we have formula tau is equal to, since there are multiple torques, so we can write sum of T into L divided by GJ. So displacement of this angle of twist of point A is equal to, for this region AC, I can write the torque AC, which is 150 Newton into meter, length of AC is 0.4 divided by G, multiply by G is how much? Let me write the value of G. So I can write G is 80 gigapascal, so 80 into 10 raised to power 9. And what about J? So J is the polar moment of inertia, which is equal to pi by 2 C power 4. So diameter is given 14 millimeter. So C will be equal to 7 millimeter, diameter divided by 2, 7. So pi by 2, 0.007 power 4. So when you put the value pi by 2, 0.007 power 4. 0.007 power 4. Okay. Now we will take the angle of twist due to this TCD. So that is minus 130 multiplied by the length of this is 0.3. So 0.3 divided by G, which is 80 into 10 to the power 9, multiplied by pi by 2 into 0.007 power 4, plus the third one is minus 170 multiplied by length is 0.5 divided by 880 into 10 to the power 9, multiplied by pi by 2, 0.007 power 4. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get angle of twist of point A will be equal to minus 0.2121 radian. The negative sign shows that this point A is moving toward this in clockwise direction. Clear? And since the answer is negative, by the right hand rule, the thumb is directed toward, if your thumb is directed toward, like if I draw this thumb, clear, and your fingers like that, clear. So what does it mean that the thumb is directed toward the ends? You can see this thumb is directed towards end E, clear, of the shaft, and therefore gear A will rotate as shown in figure. So if, what does it mean that if I draw, show you over here, so if the thumb is like that, clear, of the hand, so this negative sign means that this is point P on this gear, so this P will move toward new position, that will be this one. So this will be the angle of twist. This is theta A. So if I draw it like this is the circle. So if your point P was like this, so it will now move toward new point in this. So this will be the angle of twist pi A. Clear? Now, we are going to find out this distance, how much this point P moves. So by using this formula, distance covered by this point P, SP is equal to R multiplied by theta A. So what is R? So R is the radius of this gear, which is given as 100 millimeter. So 100 millimeter is 0.1 multiplied by minus 0.2121 radian. Since this minus sign shows the direction of the rotation, so we will neglect it because we are finding the distance, and distance can be negative. So we can find this if you multiply 0.1 to 0.1 multiplied by 0.2121, you will get this 0.2121 meter. And SP in millimeter is equal to 0.2121 into 10 raised to power 3 millimeter. So multiply by 10 raised to power 3 will give you 21.21. So 21.21 millimeter. So it means that this point P will move from this point till this point and cover this displacement or distance 21.2 millimeter, which is the answer of our this question. If you are confused about the direction, so forget about this and solve it by using your own convention and you will get the same answer. And that was all about this example 5.5. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.